It's time for Ryan's Roses. Here we go. If it's public service, if there's an issue in your world you can't sort it out, come to us and we'll try our best. It's a public service, Ryan's Roses. So, dear Ryan and Sissany, I was away on my yearly girls' weekend, something my girlfriends and I do every year. When I came home, I found out that my husband had a company come by and clean the rug in the living room. It was weird. Not something he would do. He said he spilled some food, but when I asked him what he was eating, he stumbled, changed it to wine, and just got really, really nervous. I don't know what to think. He's not the type to drink wine by himself. So she doesn't know why he had the carpets cleaned. And that's why she wants us to call him. It's in Monterey Park. Ava, good morning. What do you think he's covering up?
I don't know. I mean, why would he clean the carpet? I think he's covering up, you know, maybe an affair. Why would he drink wine? Why would he clean the carpet?
But are you saying that he stained the carpet with his affair? What's the carpet have to do with it?
Why did he clean the carpet? If he's not covering something up, why did he bring in a carpet cleaner to clean the carpet? Usually he's the type of person that would just like spray something on it, rub it,
okay,
and come back and go, what's that spot?
All right, Ava, hold on one sec. We want to get more information on this, but I have a couple more questions. I'm concerned. Hold on one second. I don't know why she thinks he couldn't have just screwed something up on the carpet and had it cleaned.
Yeah,
like, there's more to this. He's either cheated in the past or something. There's more to this. What is it, Patty?
Well, because guys don't do that.
What do you mean guys don't?
If you were to spill something in your carpet, you're going to just get a towel and try to wipe it off. You're not going to go out of your way and go call
right. He's hiding something. Like, maybe it was the other girl's pink lipstick.
That's not true, because I know with everything that I have, I know exactly the value of it, because I had it not. There was a point where I didn't have it. So now when I have it, I would definitely try and keep it clean, and I would want to salvage it.
You're an exception because you think like a girl.
True.
Thank you. We'll try and give him a call next. All right, let's get it going. We're making the roses call now. Ava thinks that when she was away, her husband had an affair, stained the carpets because he called a carpet cleaner. He could have actually spilled some on the carpet and called the carpet cleaner to clean it up. But Patty says men don't do that. Men just leave it there or put a towel on it. All right, let's. Ava, has he ever cheated on you before?
Not to my knowledge.
You know how
it's a little detail? Like, you get a little detail and it just starts niggling in your brain. Like, wait a minute, that's wrong. You know, that's the detail. That's the detail. And like, first he goes, it's food. Then he goes, it's wine. I'm like, wine? I'm the person that opens a bottle of wine. You'll maybe have a beer, but you don't drink wine. So it's details. It's like, okay, these things don't add up.
Got it. Okay, well, how long have you been married?
We're married 10 years.
We're going to call him now and offer him the roses. We'll find out who he sends them to and what he puts on the card, okay?
Okay.
Hi, may I speak to Carlos?
This is Carlos.
Hi, good morning, Carlos. My name is Eric, and I'm calling from Villa Flowers here on Orange Grove in Pasadena. How are you?
I'm doing fine. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Thank you for taking my call this morning. I know I'm sure you're very busy right now, but I just wanted to make this really quick. You've been chosen to receive a free dozen roses. They're completely free. You can send them to whoever you want today at no cost to you. All I need is the name of the person you want to send them to, a quick note, and they're on their way today before lunchtime.
Wait, you're giving me free roses?
Yes, and I'm sure you're asking why.
Yeah.
It's a promotion that we have going on in the last 2 weeks, and I would love for you to go ahead and take these roses.
Okay, but I mean, it's not going to be one of these things where I give you information and then you ask for a credit card?
No, I'm not asking for any billing information from you.
Really?
Yes, really.
Okay.
I know, it sounds crazy, right? But this is real. And I mean, I do ask that we do have one suggestion. If you can just go ahead, it's not mandatory, but we ask that you go ahead and just refer us to your friends and family.
Okay.
And that would help us a lot.
I could do that. Okay, cool. Yeah.
So it's a dozen red roses. And like I said, you can send them to whoever you want today. And I just need the name of the person you want to send them to. We can start with that.
Okay. Send them to Stella.
Stella. And it includes a note, so just let me know what you want to put on the note.
Write that THAT with a question mark.
THAT?
Yeah. She'll know.
Just that? I mean, that. Just that, that?
That, yeah.
Okay, with a question mark.
With a, yeah, that, yeah.
And signed, Carlos?
Yeah.
Carlos, it's Ryan Seacrest. Your voice is being broadcast on the radio. I need you to hear that and understand that.
What?
We have your wife, Ava, on the line, and you sent roses to Estella with that note. Who is Estella?
Who the heck is Estella? This is Ava.
Baby, what's going on?
Who is this? Will you tell me what's going on? Who is Estella that you're sending her roses?
Estella is a friend of mine helping me with something, actually.
Helping you
okay,
with
what? Is she what? Helping you with?
Well, I really don't want to talk about this on the radio
with
my wife.
Well, I want to talk about this. I want to talk about this. And this is just as good a place to talk about this as any. Who is Estella? And you better have a good answer.
She's somebody I work with. She's helping me with something. I really,
yeah,
maybe. I don't want to talk about this.
What is she helping you with? You're sending her
roses. I don't want to talk about this on the air.
Why?
Because. It's kind of like a surprise.
Yeah, I'm surprised.
What? Wait. What surprise?
You put me in a bad. It's
Carlos.
You put yourself
before,
in a bad spot, Carlos. You did this to yourself.
What does that mean on the card?
Yeah, what does that even mean?
I'm asking her a question about something she's doing for me. I need to know something.
Will you tell me what she's doing for you? I mean, that would help.
What is she doing for you?
Okay, I'll just tell you. She's a girl at work. She dresses a lot like you. She's a good friend of mine. Your birthday's coming up.
It's getting worse and worse, Carlos.
What I'm saying is, your birthday's coming up, and she's trying to help me find these special Tanzanite earrings from, like, our first date that you lost, and I wanted to replace them. So I kind of drew a picture of what they look like, and she's trying to help me look for these.
That is the most baloney thing I've ever heard.
What?
Yeah.
It's not baloney. No, it's not.
Carlos, can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Your wife was away and you had the carpets cleaned. What happened then?
Yes.
Wow. Some stuff got spilled. Some food.
First you said food, and then you said wine. You did not
what exactly stained the carpet?
Man. All right. All right. I don't want to get... Because you're going to be a little upset at me, baby, when I tell you this, but I did have a guy...
Oh, I'm upset at you.
No. I had a bunch of guys over...
You're upset, I don't think.
Hey, guys, I mean, with all due respect to your relationship, could we... What is going on here, Carlos? What? Just tell us what's happening so we can move on with our lives.
Okay, well, I had a bunch of friends over for guys weekend, and my buddy Dave, who my wife does not like, came over, and we ended up spilling a pizza all over... And a bunch of food, and I didn't want her to know that Dave was over there because she hates Dave, but I hadn't seen him in a while, and she was gone, so I thought he'd come over. He's a little drunk like he always is. I ended up spilling a thing of pizza all over, so
wife it was wine, that you were home drinking wine.
Yeah, I told her that because I didn't want her to think that I had a bunch of guys over, especially Dave.
Okay.
And
Carlos.
How do you spill a bunch of pizza? A box of pizza and a box.
He had a box of pizza, and it was open, and people taking slices, and he slipped, and he fell, and the pizza box landed.
He slipped
right side
fell.
Face down.
This is so...
Both of you, hold on. Maybe it's just me, but I'm not so sure everyone on that call is focused on the message. I don't know what's going on with those two, but I'm not so sure this is the right place and the right thing for them to be reaching out.
Right,
to
like
do.
They need to go to see a therapist.
Maybe, or others, I don't know. But I'm just saying, like, maybe Ryan's roses isn't what they need.
Yeah, this is really bad.
He slipped and fell.
Yeah, I mean, he's a pathological liar.
It doesn't make any sense. Well, it doesn't make any sense. She's trying to make sense of it, but she can't.
I don't know that I can. I'm just going to, Patty, tell them thank you, and they should really spend some time talking together or talking with a professional.
Yeah.
Okay.
Woof.
And how about that note? Doesn't add up, Estella, that. Carlos, what the heck?
Yeah, if I got a note with roses of that, I'd be like,
that?
Okay.
Estella, that, what?
Like, it must stand, THAT must stand for something that we're not putting our fingers on. Like, that hot, though.
No. Patty, yeah, we get, but no.
I think they're swingers. And he must have done something while she was away.
Has anybody noticed that anytime anything weird or aloof takes place, Patty thinks that it's that?
Yeah.
It's that. That.
Okay.
That.
Estella, that. All right. May we go just a second, come back? And I'm dying to hear what everyone else heard because I'm not so sure what to think. Good morning. So let's get back to this Ryan's Roses. Now, the story is, and we were a little delayed because of trying to track him down, but it all began, as many issues do, with a stain on the carpet. How did that stain get there? How did that stain get on that carpet?
Mm-hmm.
So Ava went out of town, right, for a few days. When she got back, her husband, Carlos, had the carpet cleaned to get rid of a food wine stain. She thinks he's having an affair, and that's how the stain got there, because it's just, it didn't sound right. It didn't add up that Carlos would go to the length of getting the carpet cleaned unless he was covering something up. So
right.
We get him on the phone, we offer the roses, and he wanted to send them to Estella. His wife's name's Ava. He wanted to send them to Estella with a note that said, well, what did the note say? It said
that.
Right. So weird.
Mm.
That. He explained to us that Estella was helping him with some lost jewelry of Ava's.
Such a lie.
Well, it's convoluted. So why would he be sending her the roses to help out? And what was he covering up? Like, I have spilled stuff. Matter of fact, just yesterday, I looked at my carpet. And I got very upset because I stained it.
Okay. With what?
I stained it with coffee.
Okay.
And you know what I tried to do? I tried to DIY it out.
Oh, this should be good. What'd you use?
I used Windex.
And why a towel. Would you spray Windex on a carpet?
It's not important. It was the closest thing that I had under the counter.
Okay.
So I've now turned that coffee stain into a paler shade of poo color.
Yeah.
So that point is, like, we stain our stuff, but what's he covering up? What's going on? Let's grab JR. JR, good morning.
Hey, good morning, Ryan.
What do you think's going down here?
Well, I think the guy's cheating.
Why? Because he stained the carpet?
No, well, one, he told her initially, because when she called and she said that he stained the carpet, it was with wine. So when you guys called him and he sent the roses to a woman, he tried to change his story and say, oh, my buddy spilled pizza. Who spills pizza on the carpet?
You don't spill pizza.
Mm-hmm.
You don't spill pizza. You don't spill it. And by the way, it has cheese on it. So you're not, you know what
right.
I mean? You're not staining.
There's a layer of protection.
Yeah,
there.
There's a layer of coverage.
Right.
The guy's not peeling the cheese off and then spilling it. Yeah.
Right. And she knows that he doesn't drink wine. So he's got to definitely have it clean. And he doesn't know how to clean wine. So he has to have it professionally clean. But if you spill pizza, it's a little bit of sauce, what? A little bit of cheese. That's no big deal.
How do you explain the card that just says that mm-hmm. to Estella?
Well, that, he's being intimate with her because, one, guys don't write something cute on a card. They write something that has a reference to something that happened. And most of the time, it's going to be something intimate. And that is probably referring to something that they know between themselves.
Mm-hmm. It's an inside joke between them. All right, thanks for calling. Here's Andrea Silmar. Good morning, Andrea. How are you?
Hi, Ryan. Good morning. So me and my coworker, we listen to Ryan's Roses every morning every Tuesdays and Mondays and Thursdays.
Yeah, I don't even know when we do it.
But Mondays and Thursdays. Like
so she was telling me that tonight.
What?
Oh, yeah, that's what I said.
Right?
I said hot, though.
Yeah, but that's not what she said. She said something totally different.
Tonight is probably makes more sense.
Is that a common thing?
You know what? That was the first time I've heard of it, but she's had issues with relationships in the past before, and that's what, I guess she looked into it and found that out.
Wow.
Wait, I'm going to do a little search.
You do a little digging.
So that sounds like a good one, though.
He's having an affair, he's staying the carpet, and then he sent the roses to Estella because he has plans for tonight.
Who knows? Maybe I don't know if he told his wife maybe he was going to be working late tonight.
Mm. All right. Well, thanks for calling. You and your coworkers are all over this.
Thank you, Ryan. Right,
bye. Jake, what do you got for me in Sherman Oaks?
Hey, guys.
Hey, buddy.
So, you're close, but I don't think when he said that, it was T-H-A-T. I think it was P, as in Paul, H-T, which stands for pretty hot and tempting.
Oh, yeah, I know. Yeah, I know that one.
Where? Hold on.
I know that one.
Yeah. I thought fat stood for dope.
No. P-H-A-T.
No. P-H-A-T stands for pretty, hot, and tempting. Mm-hmm. And I'm wondering, only because the way that he said it, it was like, she'll understand. She'll get it. I'm like, that's got to be it. Mm-hmm. That's got to be it.
I have been on this earth for more than 40 years. I've never heard fat to stand for that.
Oh, No. Fat is a thing.
I've been on earth 10 years longer than you, giving away my age. So trust me, it's been around for a minute.
Yeah, I used to use that in high school.
Yep.
But I've been misusing it. I always thought fat was dope. Like,
no.
That's fat, bro. Like, fat meaning dope.
No, it's pretty hot and tempting.
But when you're looking at a girl or, you know, someone that you're wanting or desiring to be intimate with, man, she's fat.
Mm-hmm. But, yeah, but you don't say that to a girl. She's like, what are you saying that to me for? You need to say...
No, but they do that. They'll say, you're fat. The
with
pH.
The pH.
Right, exactly.
All right. Well, listen, thank you for calling with your wisdom.
All right, guys. You have a great day.
All right, bye.
That was a TBT right there.
Throwback Tuesday?
Yeah, Throwback Thursday.
So, well, it's only Monday, so I was trying to get us just to tomorrow. Okay. Urban Dictionary says, here it is, PHT, fat.
Yeah.
Definition one, cool. Definition two, pretty hot and tempting. Mm. God, you know, I didn't know this stuff.
They used to sign that in yearbooks. Like, that was, yeah.
That's from back in the day.
Uh-huh.
All right, let's take a break. Lots of different theories coming in, but net, we think that Carlos stained the carpet with Estella while she was over and is trying to cover it all up.
Mm-hmm. I think she spilled like her lipstick or something. It was like a...
How do you spill your lipstick?
She probably did it intentionally. She probably...
Oh, you think she just did some graffiti with the lipstick?
And it was like probably like a bright pink, something that his wife never wears.
So,
I need to get rid of this.
So he invites Estella over, and she accepts the invitation.
Mm-hmm.
And Estella, being the delinquent that she is, pulls out her lipstick and just starts writing cursive on the carpet?
I mean,
what are you talking about?
Yes, girls do this stuff.
Ever since you started dating this doctor, you have spoken crazy speak.
That's not crazy. I have left, like, jewelry at guys' places before just because I intentionally...
Well, that's crazy.
It's not crazy.
You leave jewelry intentionally?
Well, yeah, because I just want them to, like, think of me the next day.
Jewelry is valuable. Do not leave jewelry.
It's not expensive. It's like.
And do you act like you didn't mean to? Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to.
Yeah.
I forgot.
Yeah.
Did you find it? I've been looking all over.
Thank you so much. You're going to come over and bring a bite? Oh, it's so sweet.
Yeah, it's such a fat conversation. All right. We're taking a break. We have to.